Greetings, everyone. My name is Rob Griffiths, senior editor at Macworld. I'm coming at you with this installment of the Macworld video. On this installment, I'm going to talk about Butler, which is one of my favorite OS X productivity applications, and all the things you can do with it that'll help you save time and be more productive with your Mac. Now, you may be wondering why I'm sitting here outside in the freezing cold talking about Butler, and the answer to that is when I started these videos, I had no experience, so I asked our resident expert, Chris Breen, for some words of wisdom. And Chris's words were, Rob, you will always, always record your videos outside because the light is so much better than it is inside. And I must admit, he's right, the light out here is wonderful. What I failed to take into account is the fact that Chris lives in California and I live in Oregon, and in December there's a big difference between those two places. In any event, let's go ahead and get started with Butler tips and tricks, and I hope you find this interesting and useful. So exactly what is Butler? Well, Butler's a program launcher, like Quicksilver or LaunchBar, but it's much more than that. It actually replaces a number of different Mac utilities, and as such, I consider it my Swiss Army knife utility of OS X. As you can see from the list, it's capable of doing quite a lot of things, and there are actually many more than that that I didn't have room to fit on the slide. Today, we'll just cover a few. The first thing I want to talk about is customizing Butler's setup. By default, you'll see two icons and a search box in your menu bar when you install Butler. Now, that's a lot of menu bar space to give up to Butler, and you don't really have to have it that way. The key is going into Butler Customize to set things up the way you want it. In here, you'll see six gray bars, and these gray bars denote areas. So there's a hidden area where you won't see commands, but if I do Control Space as shown there, I can type Text Edit to launch Text Edit. So that's the program launcher. But then there are also spaces here for the menu bar positions, left, natural, center, right. And as you can see, the entry This Mac, Bookmarks, and Web Search Google correspond to the three things you see in the menu bar. And if I expand This Mac and then activate the menu, you'll see that they match switch users, etc. Now, what I can do is I can actually just take one of these entries, let's say Web Search Google, and drag it to the menu bar right, and it moved over there. Or I can drag it into This Mac from the menu bar natural position. And at that point, it will actually disappear from the menu bar. And I can do the same thing with bookmarks. And now you'll notice the menu bar has but one icon on it. And inside of that icon, I see bookmarks and web search Google. This is a much better way to use Butler because it now only takes one menu bar position. So that was a quick look at the configuration section. Now I want to switch over to preferences and talk about a few of these. In general, this is where you tell Butler's launcher where to look for programs. There's a gear icon here where you can update and you can click plus or minus to add or remove directories where you store your programs. Another thing to look at here is in the section for pasteboard. This is the multi-clipboard support in Butler, and you can change the number here and maybe keep 10 pasteboards, and if you do images, maybe you want to make them 1500 kilobytes, and you can change the size of the pasteboard box that shows up, and we'll demonstrate this in more detail later. Finally, there's an editing box where you have drag and drop corners. You can drag and drop objects on those corners to put them into Butler's interface on the configuration screen. Now, the first Butler feature I'd like to talk about are search engines. Butler has this amazingly cool ability to search the web regardless of what browser you're using, or even if you're running your browser. And as you can see from the shot here, it comes configured with a lot of predefined search engines from Google, news, dictionaries, computers. There's a lot of stuff here that's already defined. And as you look into these, you can see that they're defined by a prefix and a suffix. And then essentially the word that you're searching for goes between the prefix and the suffix. But let's say there's a search engine you want to use that isn't in this long list of existing search engines. How do you add your own? As an example, I'll use a website I like to go to a lot called hyperjeff.net. He has a huge list, almost 20,000 strong, of applications. And if I search here for test, you can see it comes up with quite a long list of results. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the URL from the search results and I'm going to copy it, and then I'm going to go back over to Butler. And I'm going to click a plus sign down in the corner here and activate the contextual menu. Let me make sure we can see that on the screen. I'm going to click the plus sign and pick search engine to add a new search engine to Butler. As you can see, it named it Google and duplicated the one I'd chosen. So I'll rename it to Hyperjeff Apps. And then I'm going to paste in what I copied from the web. I'm going to erase the actual word I searched for. And because there was nothing after that word, I'm going to leave suffix blank. And that's it. I've defined a new search engine for Hyperjeff Apps website. And I'm done as far as defining the search engine. Now, how do I actually use this new search engine? Well, I go back to the configuration side of Butler, and I'm going to go down and add the search engine I just created into the configuration. As you can see, there's one here already for Web Search Webster, and earlier you saw Web Search Google. So I'm going to click the plus sign again, and in this case, I'm going to go into Smart Item, and I'm going to select Web Search. And you'll see this will add a new web search in. I'm going to go ahead and type a name for it. And after I've done that, I go over to search engine, and I click the pop-up, and you can see that HyperGIF apps is right there in the list. And the last thing I want to do is define a hotkey that will bring up the search engine. In this case, Control Option J. So now to use it, all I do is press Control Option J, and let me move this over. You can see I have a floating box that has a text input space, and it says HyperGIF apps below that, and I type test, and there is the search on HyperGIF's website for all the test apps. This ability to run searches on the web, regardless of what program you're running, is for me a great time saver. I don't have to reach for the mouse, I don't have to launch a browser, I just press a hotkey, and up comes my web search box. The second Butler feature I'd like to show you is containers, and containers are really nothing more than folders, but in Butler, a container is actually a pop-up menu. So you can build a pop-up menu for anything you want with a few mouse clicks and drags. I'm going to start by clicking the plus sign and adding a new container, and drag it so it's at the top of the hidden area all by itself. I'll type a name for it, we'll call it my documents, and I'm going to assign it a hotkey so I can activate it via the keyboard. In this case, I'll use Control Option D. Now here's the key. I want to tell it to open a menu near the mouse, not launch everything that's inside this container. So now I'm just going to go bring over a Finder window, and I'm just going to pick some stuff at random and drag it in here. So I'll add my virtual machines directory, and now I press the hotkey, and you'll see that I get a pop-up menu that shows virtual machines, and it's fully navigable. So let's go back to the Finder. I'll grab something else, maybe my Mac MAME folder, drag that in, drop it. And again, I reactivate the shortcut, and now all of a sudden Mac MAME is there, and it's fully navigable as well. So you can keep doing this as often as you want. I'll go back and we'll just go get one more out of the Finder. Maybe we'll grab the Pictures folder, drop it in there. And once again, we'll activate, and now I have all three available and navigable. So this is one of the things I use Butler for the most. I have all sorts of folders in my hot projects, and I can activate all of them with the touch of a hotkey. The final Butler feature I'd like to talk about today is the pasteboard, which essentially is a multi-clipboard. So instead of OS X's one-item clipboard, you can keep as many items you want in your pasteboard, and they'll stay there even across restarts. And this is predefined in Butler out of the box, so there's a bunch of different options here. I'm going to go ahead and look at the one that's labeled Paste and Change Order, and it's got a shortcut set up, which is Control Option V. The only thing I want to change is I want to change it to open a menu near the mouse. And I'm going to go ahead and press my hotkey now, and you'll see here are the 8 items that are in my multi-item pasteboard. So let's go ahead and copy something. I'll grab a screenshot of these two little buttons, and now I'll open the pasteboard again, and you can see that they're at the top of the list. The great thing about a multi-clipboard is that you don't have to do copy, switch, paste, switch, copy, switch, paste, switch, copy, switch, paste. Instead, you can copy, 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 switch, paste, 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 paste. This is a much more logical way to work and a great time saver. So there you have a quick look at some of my favorite Butler tips and tricks. It really is a powerful program, as you saw in some of those videos, and it also has a complicated interface. But learning that interface is time well spent, because you'll soon be able to recover it in time saved with all the things you can make Butler do for you. So if you've been looking for a tool to help your productivity, take a look at Butler. You might be amazed at what it can do for you. Until next time, this is Rob Griffiths signing off and heading back inside where it's nice and warm and dry. See you next time.